Children, today's topic is DNA, finger printing. First thing is we need to take the person's cells. Person's cells from where they can be obtained. When you walk around, your hair will fall. This hair can be act as a sample. Or person cells means sample should be taken. Your skin cells that are shed, they can act. If you have any blood test, blood cells can be extracted for that. Or even if any organ transplant is performed, or a piece of organ or a piece of a tissue can be separated from our body, cut off from our body. Anything can act as a sample. From this sample, first thing that is to be done is DNA is isolated. Okay, from the entire cell, the cells are taken and from that DNA is isolated. After the DNA is isolated, okay, the DNA is isolated from the cells. After the DNA is isolated, it is allowed to digest. A process digestion of DNA is done by nucleotidases. Nucleotidases digest these DNA into small fragments. From these fragments, by a process called centrifugation is performed, and by this process repetitive DNA are separated. Repetitive DNA are those parts of DNA. Every chromosome has some repetitive DNA. Those parts of DNA which occur hundreds of times or thousands of times in one chromosome. So those are separated. This repetitive DNA is usually same if the individuals are same. The sample taken and the suspect is same, then both will be same. If the sample taken and suspect is not same, both will be different. So the repetitive DNA is usually isolated. After the isolation, this DNA this repetitive DNA belongs to different chromosomes. And a process called electrophoresis is done. DNA is a negatively charged. DNA is a negatively charged. So electrophoresis is a technique in which a small amount of sample gel is taken. Gel means, you know, agar gel. You know the Vaseline jelly, same like that, there will be a jelly-like substance used in laboratories. That jelly-like substance is applied on a small petri dish-like container, and electrolysis is a process in which two electrodes are connected. One will be a cathode, one will be an anode. Okay, and electricity is run. So what happens, all the charged molecule in this between, whatever charged molecules are there, they start moving from one direction to another direction. Okay, and this process is called as electrophoresis. Okay, the process is called as electrophoresis. And what happens, the DNA fragments that are added, these repetitive DNA fragments will be added. Based on their molecular weight, the movement, how much speed they'll move, that depends upon molecular weight, yes or no? So if the DNA fragment is small, it will reach this corner. If the DNA fragment is large, it can move only some distance. So based on that, different DNA fragments are separated. Okay? The DNA fragments are separated based on this method of electrophoresis. After that, they will be transferred onto a, they are transferred onto a nylon sheet or nitrocellulose sheet membrane. Nylon membrane or nitrocellulose membrane. How it is transferred? A method called southern blotting. Southern blotting is a technique in which over this gel, the nylon sheet or nitrocellulose membrane will be placed. On that, several other layers of tissue papers will be placed. Okay? If this is the gel, on this nylon membrane is placed, over the several layers of tissue papers will be placed, weight is placed over that. So that, you know, if something is there on the jelly substance, that it will be taken by a blotting, that technique is called as blotting. So all that is present on the gel will be overlapping on this nylon sheet. So that will transfer to nylon sheet. This is called as blotting. Suppose you are adding some color to a paper, color to a gel and putting some paper on that, what will happen? You can see the same print on this sheet. That is called as blotting. The same technique is applied in case of southern blotting also. Over this jelly-like substance, nylon sheet or nitrocellulose membrane is placed. Over that, tissue papers will be placed and some weight is applied. And it is left overnight, 14-15 hours it is left. What will happen? Whatever DNA is present on that will be transferred to this nylon membrane or nitrocellulose membrane. Now it is again performed. It is added with VTNR. VTNR means variable number tandem repeats. This is a type of repetitive DNA which is found in satellite of chromosomes. So chromosome structure, when we discussed, we saw that there are structures, secondary constriction is present, and there are structures like this called satellites. They consist of so much amount of repetitive DNA. This chromosome has so much repetitive DNA, which is almost the same chromosome. Each chromosome has similar type of repetitive DNA. So this repetitive DNA which is present in this chromosome will be more. That's all. That is only difference. Okay, repetitive DNA, if it is more number of times, then it is called as variable number of tandem repeats. For this VTNR, a small probe is attached. Probe is something which is radioactive substance. A radioactive substance is attached to this tandem repeats. Okay, same like how this repetitive DNA is separated from DNA. In the same way, variable number of repeats will be separated and they are secured from the sample which is found at the crime location or suspected location. That small amount of whatever DNA is there, from that this VTNRs will be separated. And that VTNRs will be added with a radioactive substance. What is the purpose of radioactive substances? When you study it in a nylon or nitrocellulose, it shows that radioactivity. It shows that, you know what is radioactivity. It is shining. So when it shines, you can easily identify it. Okay. This are usually complementary to this DNA which is checked. Okay. They are complementary. Complementary to the original repetitive DNA, complementary. So all the DNA will have the strand which is running from 3 prime to 5 prime, one strand that is running from 5 prime to 3 prime. So for repetitive DNA is taken from one strand, and VT and NAS will be taken from opposite strand. So they will be complementary to each other. Okay. After the southern blotting is completed, VT and NARs are added to that. VT and NARs are added to that. Nylon sheet is there for that. VT and NARs will be added, and they will be allowed to form that complementary basis. Okay, the VT and NARs will be added to that nylon sheet, and they will be allowed to form that complementary attachment is formed. Okay. Once the complementary attachment is formed, the radioactivity of this probe helps us to identify this repetitive DNA. If there is a match, only the pairing will take place. Pairing will take place, and we can see it as a complementary base pairs. If the pairing does not take place, it remains as a single unit. No pairing will take place, so that will not be the suspect. That DNA is not of suspect. If the pairing takes place only, that is a suspect. How it is identified whether pairing is taken place or not? Autoradiography is a technique to identify the radioactive substances. Autoradiography. So by using this technique, whether this DNA probe is paired or not, it is identified. If it is paired, the suspect and the DNA DNA at the crime scene will be same. If not, both will be different. Okay. So that is about DNA fingerprinting. Biotechnology principles and processes. What is biotechnology? Biotechnology You might have seen that diabetes patients are injected with insulin. From where that insulin comes? It is produced from a bacteria. From a bacteria, this insulin is produced in large quantities. Okay? So every hormone defective person is introduced. Any hormone that is defective is produced from any biotechnology source like this. From any organism, from any living organism, and it is introduced into the body of defective organism. How is it possible? Because of biotechnology. So what is biotechnology? It is using the organisms, either using organisms or enzymes from organisms. Enzymes from organisms. To produce useful human products. Useful human products. Biogas uses enzymes. Production of several hormones in different patients is done by this. Organisms are directly taken, and from that useful products are produced. In this biotechnology, there are two techniques. Two major techniques that are involved in biotechnology are genetic engineering. First method. Second one is bioprocess engineering. Genetic engineering is modifying the DNA. DNA, if it is genetic material of our organism, is modified by adding some nucleotides or by removing some nucleotides, by adding one complete gene or by removing one complete gene. If any modification is done in the host DNA, what will be the result? The external behavior of that organism will change. Okay. Why it will change? We already know this. Like in case of sickle cell anemia, one amino acid is changing. That is not a complete gene also. One small code is changing. One codon is changing. That's all. Because of that codon is also changing because of one nucleotide or two nucleotides. That small change is bringing change in the complete behavior of the organism. If we can isolate that gene of a person and add the correct amino acid, there in case of sickle cell anemia, glutamate it should be added instead of that valine. Okay? Instead of that, instead of valine being added, the sickle cell anemia patients, just DNA can be isolated and checked that instead of valine, glutamate is added. How this can be done? By changing one nucleotide of the patient's DNA or two nucleotides. Okay? In this way, modifying the DNA to bring about change in behavior. How change in behavior? If the person is not having sickle cell anemia, anemia is causing swelling of organs, very inactive body, sluggish body. This all things will not be there. Phenotype means external characters will change of that organisms. Okay? If external change of external characters of organism change because of one addition of one or few nucleotides or one or few genes, okay, that will be very helpful. And this process of changing is called genetic engineering. Changing DNA by addition or deletion of a gene or a nucleotide. Because of this, phenotype will change. Phenotype means external characters of organisms. External characters of organisms will change. External character of organisms will change. And this process is called as genetic engineering. Okay? Genetic engineering is a technique by which DNA of organism is changed by addition or deletion of any one small segment of DNA, and as a result, the total external character of that gene will be changed. Next one is bioprocess engineering. Bioprocess engineering involves the total process will be introduced into any microorganisms. Production of any microorganism like bacteria, fungus in a sterile condition. Like for example, take the production of penicillin. Penicillium notatum is an antibiotic that is produced by fungus. Fungus should be grown in a sterile conditions. Fungus should be grown in a sterile medium. A medium where, what is a sterile medium? Sterile medium is a medium where there is no infectant. No infectant. Okay? Sterile medium, the place where you go grow this type of organisms will be very sterile. You are not allowed into the room, except one or two persons, more persons will not be allowed in that sterile chamber will be there. Okay, like a closed room. In that always there will be maintenance of certain temperature where microorganisms will not grow. Very low temperature will be maintained. And you are not allowed to touch anything without gloves. Sterilization of gloves also is very important. Some sterilization means you are adding some sterilization liquid, like you add sanitizer, and sterilization is done. Then only you touch anything. Okay, that room is also maintained sterilely, that no organism enters into that, dust should not enter into that. It should be regularly cleaned. That type of environment. Why it should be maintained like that means, if a small amount of air from outside enters into that room also, air contains bacteria, air contains virus, air contains fungus, all this, anything can grow. In a sterile, this sterile medium where you are growing fungus means you are supplying all the nutrients that fungus requires. Nutrients are there, microorganisms are there, definitely growth of microorganisms will be there. So a sterile environment should be created inside that chamber, and growth of these organisms which are required should be done. Okay, that is only first. After that, the total process should be run inside that organism. Here, take for example, production of penicillium notatum. is done under fungus. The total process is of fungus is used. Or sometimes a small amount of DNA is introduced into that organism. And suppose I said you that insulin is produced by bacteria. Into that bacteria, the insulin synthesizing DNA is introduced and it is monitored in such a way that it produces insulin. That insulin is taken out, it is multiplied by PCR and so much amount of insulin is produced. Okay, this is bioprocess engineering. Okay, cells are produced. In that cells, either antibodies can be produced, enzymes can be produced, or even vaccines can be produced by this method. Vaccines can be produced by this bioprocess engineering method using microorganisms to produce. This is changing DNA to produce. This is using microorganisms to produce something. And for this process, okay, we are left with only 4 minutes. We'll discuss about this